Good evening and welcome to Encounter Church's Facebook Live. This is the evening that the Lord has made. We shall rejoice and be glad in it. We have had such an interesting week thus far with the elections, but you know what? God is large and in charge, isn't he? Awesome. I know Apostle's been speaking about how it was going to be a pretty, you know, interesting week, and it certainly has, just like he has spoken it out. So we're going to pray because you know what? God, his kingdom is coming and his kingdom is going to reign big and mighty, right? In every way. Amen. So let's pray. All righty. So Father God, we thank you for this night and we thank you for your blessings upon each and every one of us. Lord, your anointing is fresh and new every day, and we thank you for it, Father God. We thank you for your mercies being new to us every day, Father. Thank you, Lord, so much. The joy of the Lord is our strength, and we continue to honor you and love you, Father God, because you are awesome and magnificent. Lord, you have a word for us tonight, and we're excited. Thank you, Father God, for your blessings upon each and every person that's listening, each and every person that's viewing in, Father, in the name of Jesus. Amen. Amen. Make sure you tap your share button. Make sure you make your comments. I love your comments. They're so beautiful. And make sure you tell a friend and tell them about Encounter Church, okay? And tell them about how much Jesus loves them. All right? Well, I love you so much. See you in a little bit. Pastor Derek and Amy are going to lead us in a song. All right. I love you guys.
Praise the Lord. This evening, in this moment, wherever we're at, let's set aside our affections, set aside our attention, and truly just push into worship with the Lord. Enter in tonight. Let's give him our hearts, give him our lives, give him our moment, this moment right now. Amen? Amen. Let's do that right now. Oh, we will worship the Lamb of glory. We will worship the Lamb of glory.
My hands lifted high to the sky. Father, we glorify you. Glory to your name, my God. Glory to the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. Bless your wonderful name, my Lord God. We give you all the glory and all the honor and all the praise in Jesus' name. Pastor Derek, glory in the highest. Welcome, church family. We love you. We love you. Counter Church, we love you. Facebook friends, we love you. Let's continue to engage as we honor and worship the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. Glory in the highest. Glory in the highest. Let's sing together. There you go. Let's engage together.
Glory in the
highest. To you, Lord. Go ahead, tell him. Right to his face, sing it to him.
Glory in the highest. Glory in the highest. Glory in the highest. To you, Lord.
We love you, Lord. Sing it like this. One more time. He loves that sound. He loves it. Ooh. Ooh. Ooh.
Ooh.
We love you, Lord. Precious anointing is in this house. Sweet anointing. It's a fresh anointing descending right now. Fresh anointing. Sing glory.
Glory in the highest. Glory in the highest. Glory in the highest.
One more time. Oh, just soak in his presence. Soak it in. God just deposited this in my spirit afresh. I speak a fresh recharge upon you right now. I declare in the mighty name of Jesus, a recharge right now in your spirit, in your emotions, in your heart, in your body, as we engage together, there you go. I pray a fresh anointing. Oh, my Lord, where would we be without the anointing? We declare a fresh recharge of the anointing of the Holy Spirit upon you now. I told you on Sunday, some would be happy over the elections, some would not be happy. I told you. I told you that I don't think it's going to be called on election night. I told you that. I'm saying this for a reason. And let me tell you before we go on, because I know you're very careful with your comments. Calvin Church, I just want to pay you a compliment for being very diplomatic. We need diplomacy in our lives. We need diplomacy restored back in pulpits. We need diplomacy restored in us, individually, collectively, diplomacy. And I want to thank you, Encounter Church, for being diplomatic by not acting like a Republican or not acting like a Democrat or a Libertarian or an Independent. Thank you. You can be that, but when we're part of God's kingdom for such a time as this, all that's put aside. So even now, for at least now, last night is put aside, because this is not Fox News tonight. Somebody say, praise the Lord. This is not Fox News tonight. This is not CNN News tonight. But we do have a projection. We do have a projection. Jesus Christ is King of Kings and Lord of Lords.
Hallelujah.
Come on, somebody.
Yes.
Jesus Christ is King of Kings and Lord of Lords. But I know this has been a strenuous, stressful time. And for many, it still is. And not just with the elections, but just life itself. But Encounter Church, again, thank you for being Christian-minded, Christ-like, especially during the political season, of not causing any strife or any division or politicking, you know what I mean by that, but taking the side of the Lord. And it's okay to have our convictions about other things. That's fine. But thank you as a church. Thank you as a church for collectively being mature. Yeah. Thank you, Encounter Church, for being mature. You see, there's a reason why we are a diversified church. There's a reason why we're diversified, because God can trust us. He can trust us through His grace, that is. He can trust us. That's why we have all colors. Our church is made up of Democrats, Republicans, Independents, in the natural, white, black, Asian, Hispanic. Is he even an Italian guy like me? But we're diversified. We're the kingdom. We're the kingdom. Remember, who's elected for office is 4 years, maybe 8 years. But the King of Kings and Lord of Lords is eternal. The King of Kings, you may want to comment if you'd like. The King of Kings and Lord of Lords is eternal. Thank you, Amy. The King of Kings and Lord of Lords is eternal. So again, before I go on, and I'm not done releasing the anointing on you. I'm not. But I just want to compliment you, Encounter Church, for being mature. Not perfect. Not perfect. But thank you for being mature, especially during this election season. You know, listen to me very carefully. This season has caused a lot of strife. This season has caused a lot of division. It's hurt a lot of churches. This season has. It's hurt our nations. But we as Encounter Church looked at it as an opportunity to come together and dwell together and get to know each other more by the Spirit. So again, I can't say this enough. You know how you are when your kids do something good, you get proud of them. I remember JD, his first Little League baseball game. He was 4 years old, and his team, they were the Braves, just down the street from here. His team, they were the Braves. He was 4 years old, and he was playing T-ball. And I'll never forget, the ball's placed on the tee, and most of the kids would not even hit the ball. Pastor Derek. Most of the kids would not even hit the ball that's on the tee. Most of them, with their big bat or little bat, they would hit the tee. Not the ball, on the tee. Kind of like the way I golf. But most of the kids would hit the tee and not the ball on the tee. So I remember with JD, he was 4 years old, and he would take a whack with all his might, and he would not hit the ball. He would hit the tee. But as a result of hitting... I love to brag about my kids. I love to brag about you. This is where I'm going. But when the ball, I mean, when the bat would hit the tee, the ball would just fall to the ground. It would hardly even roll. It would hardly even roll. The ball would just fall to the ground. And we were like, wow, James David. Wow, JD. What a shot. Keep running, keep running. And he's chugging the first base. And the young boy or girl throwing the ball to first base, throws it and it goes between their legs. We're saying, JD, go to second base. And the second baseman gets the ball and he throws it to the third baseman and goes over the third baseman's head. JD, go to third. JD, come home. Ah! And we'd scream. We'd be so excited. Even gave my son a trophy at the end of the year. Gave him a trophy. He didn't even hit the ball.
Didn't matter.
He's my son. You get it now. I knew you got it, but you get it even more now. He's my son. Keep sharing, keep commenting if you'd like. He's my son. I was excited. I was proud of him. There were times when he'd get up at bat. This is after T-ball now, when he was 5 and 6 years old. In fact, when he was 5 years old, he was on the Yankees. When he was 5, he was on the Yankees. And it was coach pitch. You know, that you just lob it in. And he would take that bat and swing. And sometimes he would miss. And I'd say, James David! JD, that was great. And he'd look at me like, what you talking about, Willis? He's thinking like, Dad, I didn't even hit the ball. Yeah, but it was a great swing. See, that's the way we are with our children. And that's the way your Heavenly Father is with you. Even when you feel insignificant, even when you feel like you're not important. Imagine if I feel this way, Pastor Derek. If you feel that way about Gideon. In fact, Gideon's 4, isn't he?
He's 4, yep.
Gideon's 4.
Yes, he is.
If you feel that way about Gideon, some of the things he does. I felt that way about my son when he missed the ball. Or at best, when he hit the tee. And the ball just dropped. How much all the more does your Heavenly Father love you and is so proud of you? So again, I'm so proud of you, Encounter Church, for not being a divisive people. Not taking one side or the other. Yeah, thank God for the privilege to vote. Thank God for that. But not allowing that to distract our walk with God or break fellowship with anyone in our church or anyone in the body of Christ or any family or friends. It's not worth it. Thank you for being so mature. Thank you. I appreciate that. So you say, well, now, what do you have to say about the election? Well, let me just conclude by saying I'm so proud of you for being a United Church Encounter. Because tonight, God's commanded blessings are going to flow upon you. They really are. They really are. Pastor Derek, thank you so much. Thank you. God's commanded blessings are going to fall upon you. Why? Because you've been tried. We've been tried. And we've passed the test. Now, there'll always be another test. That's okay. There'll always be another testimony. So what I have to say about the elections is, because this is God's night, This is God's night. What I have to say now is what I said the day before the elections on Facebook. And I'll repeat myself. Because apostles are proactive. Not reactive, proactive. Now, sometimes you have to react, but it's more important to be proactive. In fact, that's what the word means in 1 Corinthians 12:28, first apostles. The word first is proton, first in governmental authority. So I like to do things before they happen. I don't know if you noticed, I think 3 weeks ago in our drive-in service, and we're on 59. Cars, 35,000 cars a day go by. And many cars on Sunday, they pass by and they honk their horns. I love it. They're like joining in with us. But a few weeks ago, there was an extremely loud motorcycle. You guys remember that? I mean an extremely loud motorcycle. Very loud. The thing should be outlawed. That sound. The sound, that is, okay? It was like, but I sensed it coming from a distance. And at that moment, I took the mic and I put it by my mouth and I started to praise the Lord. And my praise drowned out the sound of that motorcycle. Now, again, please, I'm not against motorcycles. They're not for me, but I'm not against you. I believe you should wear a helmet, you know, protect your head. But the Lord allowed me to be one step ahead of that sound, because the Bible says God's looking for a certain sound. And by staying ahead, some hardly even knew that the motorcycle passed by. Why? Because I was proactive. So I'm thankful that we are proactive. And on Monday, here's what I put on Facebook. And this is what I said or say yesterday on Election Day. Today, after Election Day, even though it's not finalized, I said, and I say to you, Jesus is still and will always remain Lord no matter what. If you want to comment that, you may. Many of you saw that on Facebook. I'll say it again. Jesus is still and will always remain Lord no matter what. So folks, there's no need to panic. If you're excited, praise the Lord. If you're not excited, get excited. Why? Because Jesus is still and will always remain Lord no matter what. See, people with the spirit of religion, they don't get me. That's okay. They didn't get Jesus either. Legalistic spirits, they don't like me. Legalistic spirits, Pharisaical spirits don't like me. That's okay. They didn't like Jesus. But Jesus, he was a friend of sinners. Jesus was a friend of sinners. And the Lord told me years ago, son, the calling upon you is different. It's apostolic, proton, governmental order of authority. And to operate in the flow in that gift, son, you have to be on top of it. You got to bring your A game every time and be one ahead of the enemy. Be not stereotypical, but prototypical. Prototypical. Don't just fit in. Stand out. So again, I compliment you, Encounter Church, for being a diversified church who loves Jesus with all their heart. That's right. I know some don't understand your walk or your values, but you see, you're the one working out your salvation for yourself. So you just keep trucking along and keep loving your family, your brother, do what he's going to do. We pray for America. We pray for unity in our nation. We pray for our leadership in America, that God will have his way. We pray even regarding this election. We pray like the prophets of old prayed. Sovereign Lord, thou knowest. When the Lord said to the prophet, Son of man, can these bones live? What did the prophet say? Thou knowest. You alone know. You're sovereign, Lord. Trust in the Lord with all your heart. Lean not to your own understanding. In all your ways acknowledge him, and he will direct your path. So we say, Lord, regarding this election, sovereign Lord, have your way. He's not going to have the way of the people. He's large and he's in charge. And we pray that God would give wisdom to all those in leadership, in authority, in the White House. Everyone, every Democrat, every Republican. But church, again, I'm so proud of you, especially during this stressful season where many churches have been split and divided over politics, over a man, a woman. No, we're not that way. And we will never, never, ever, hear me? If there's somebody watching tonight that does not know me, we will never compromise the validity of this word, never, for anybody. God forbid. Somebody comment, God forbid. But we do have unity through diversity. And you see, for God's commanded blessings to flow, there has to be unity. For his commanded uncontrolling blessings to flow, there has to be unity. So we say, Father, may your kingdom come and your will be done over what's left and remains in this election. Your will be done for our future as a nation in the White House and people of God in your house. That's what I pray. That's what I pray. I don't always agree with everybody. Sometimes the person I vote for wins the election. Sometimes they don't win the election. It's gone back and forth. But I don't live by elections. I live by the elect. That's right. The Word of God says we are the elect of God. I feel this thing. The chosen ones. The called out ones. So at Encounter Church, we don't bite. We don't bite the bait of Satan. Yes, we believe in the uncompromising Word of God. Yes, we do. Yes, we do. And you know, the most important thing is not who you voted for, but who did you tell about Jesus today? Because that's eternal. That's eternal. Jesus is my hero. Jesus is my superstar. Jesus is my hero. Always has and always will. No president, no congressman, mayor, alderman, in all due respect, can change your life but Jesus. No one can change America but Jesus. In fact, let's pray for America. And I'm not done praying for you. Father, we pray for America. We pray for our leadership. We pray your hand of protection and wisdom. And Lord, we pray that your kingdom will come and your will be done. But I pray that tonight, Lord, we will all be joyful. We will all be joyful. Because, Lord, our joy is not dependent on a party or a person or a political affiliation. Our joy is in the Lord. For the joy of the Lord is your strength. So we pray, God, for revival in America, in our streets, our cities. Touch and protect our children, our first responders, our apostles, prophets, evangelists, pastors, teachers. Protect them all, we pray, Lord. Those in hospitals, the sick and the shut in, the lonely, the outcast. Touch them, we pray, Father. Our families, our unsaved loved ones. Oh, that we'd have the passion for the lost. Like some have had the passion for the elections. Father, renew the flame of evangelism in us, please. May our priorities be where you would have them, jealous God. Jealous God. So Lord, again, we pray for our nation. And the joy of the Lord is our strength. Not the joy of Donald, and not the joy of Joe, but the joy of the Lord is our strength. The joy of the Lord is our strength. Now, church, I didn't forget this because it's still in me and it's still on me. I impart to you a recharge of an anointing, I pray. An impartation right now. That's why my hands are stretched. An impartation of fresh joy. Fresh strength. Renewed energy. And hope for your life. Hope for your city, your region, your community, your church, your churches, your nation, the nations. Because Jesus is the King. I release it now by the word of God and the words of my mouth through the laying on of hands right now. Receive right through that device, hand to hand, heart to heart, head to head, mind to mind, in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. And if you're dealing with a sickness right now, I declare healing in your body now. From the crown of your head to the soles of your feet, wellness in Jesus' name. Holy, holy, this anointing is so strong. We've passed the test, church. We passed the test. And the uncontrolling blessings of the Lord, the commanded blessings of the Lord are upon us now. I feel it upon me now. Upon you now, it's coming now like a wave. Some got distracted. Some in America, some in some churches got distracted. Maybe somebody watching, you got distracted. But now we're back in focus. And for many of us, we're staying in focus. Because God's commanded blessing is yours. Uncontrollable. Jesus is still and will always remain Lord no matter what. So be happy. Whether you're Republican, Democrat, Independent, rejoice. Because your salvation is not in a man or a term, but in the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. Father, may thy will be done, thy kingdom come, in Jesus' name. Yep. I have the mind of Christ. You have the mind of Christ. Some of you are trying to figure out, well, who do you vote for? I got the mind of Christ, and so do you. Don't go there. You see, for this commanded blessing to take place uncontrollably, you got to be in position. And part of that is your spirit, your mind, your spirit, your soul, your body. I'll tell you this. My vote is for the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords every day. Amen. Amen. And let God determine the rest of what's going to happen. He can do a better job than you or me or any news anchor or any network. Let God be God. Amen. Amen. Oh, look at you all. Look at you all. Look at you all. Look at you all. Thank you, guys. This is God's time. This is God's night. Yep, I'm proud of you. And we're on top of our game. Don't worry, be happy. Mama Boehner said, don't worry, be happy. She rocks it out, man. She rocks it out. Huh. I have the mind of Christ. There you go, Candy. Yes, Lord. Hallelujah, Audia. Lourdes, I have the mind of Christ. Amy, let God do the rest. Sally, amen. Teresa, we miss you. Amen, she says. Yep. Adrian, amen. Nanette, Father God is in control. You got that right. You got that right. Marcia, yep, praying hands. Hi, Kelly. Yep, Sherry, God is in control. God's time. You got that right. You got that right. Praise the name of Jesus. Yes, Edwin, amen. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Amen and amen, Patrick. Yep. Let God be God. Right, Eileen? There you go. All right. You know, it's not always being a pastor, especially this time of year, when a lot of stuff happens in your country. But I will never, I'll say it again. I will never compromise the integrity of the Word of God for a man or woman, not even my own family, my own children. This Word is eternal, it's infallible. And this is what we stand on. Some of you may say, but I don't understand my brother who does this. Why would he act that way? Why would he vote for this? Why would she say that? Why would she vote? You know, the Bible says, come, let us reason together. We don't all have the answers. Come, let us reason together. See, a proud person, they have all the answers. In fact, God resists the proud, but he gives grace to the humble. He gives grace to the humble. Anyway, that's all I'm going to share about that for now. And in the future, as the Lord leads me, we'll talk more. But stay focused. Now, I'm talking about in regards to politics and the election. Because we have an eternal life with Jesus Christ. And no president has ever changed the world but Jesus. And no one ever will but Jesus. No party but the Prince of Peace. Amen. Amen. Let me hear you. Amen. This past Sunday, we spoke about uncontrollable God's commanded blessings. You receive God's commanded blessings. You receive God's commanded blessings through dwelling together in unity. Dwelling together in unity. Imagine a Republican and a Democrat sitting together during the election last night and walking in unity. That's revival. Well, guess what? Encounter Church is a church that dwells together in unity. To receive God's commanded blessings, you receive them through unity in our community, our local church. But not just any unity, coming together and dwelling in unity. Coming together and dwelling in unity. You receive God's uncontrollable, commanded blessings through dwelling together in unity. And that's why old Slewfoot, you ever hear the term Slewfoot? The devil, Beelzebub, Satan. He will do anything he can to distract us. As a nation, as a church, your family. But when there is unity in our community like we have, and it's going to remain. When we dwell together in unity, again, that dwelling together is not just coming together, it's being together where iron sharpens iron, which means during the sharpening process, you may get cut a little bit and you may bleed a little bit. It's a sign of covenant. I'm talking spiritually now. There's something about dwelling together through thick and thin. And that's what we've done as a church. That's why we've survived every storm. Because you guys rock. Remember, my little son JD, he wouldn't even hit the ball. He hit the tee, and I'd get so excited. And I'd clap and applaud. Well, I applaud you tonight. Because you are rocking it out in Calendar Church. Facebook friends. You guys know how to step up to the plate and be the body of Christ. We're not perfect, but I love you for that. Thank you. All right. This commanded uncontrollable blessing comes through oneness, submission. Obedience. Humility. I just add more as God gives me more. Being in position. Your heart in position. Your mind in position. Your body in position. The New Testament church in the book of Acts was built on dwelling together in unity. Acts 2:44. Dwelling together in unity. All the believers dwelt together in unity. And as one had a need, another would take care of it. If one was blessed, they were all blessed. If one was hurting, they all cried and hurt together. All who believed dwelt together. And they all acted the same way. Did you hear me? They all acted the same way. That's unity. That's unity. They all acted the same way. That's what it means to dwell together. Hallelujah. And therefore, they were blessed the same way. All their needs were met above and beyond according to the Lord's riches and glory. Oh, yeah. We thank God for the 30, 60, 100, even thousandfold. Oh, yeah. I sound like a Canadian. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. We thank God for the good, acceptable, and perfect. Oh, yeah. We thank God for the good measure. Pastor Derek's laughing. He's over there laughing. You can't see him, but he's laughing. Because he's from Minnesota. He's from Minnesota. We thank God for the good measure, pressed down, shaken together, and running over. Oh, yeah. We appreciate that our cup runneth over. Oh, yeah. We do. But we thank the Lord that He is El Shaddai. He's more than enough. But when I said this on Sunday, you guys went nuts. I mean, you guys got out of your cars. You get out of your cars. I mean, this is Chicago. You get out of your cars, you were screaming and shouting when I said, he's El Shaddai. And I said, if he blesses you beyond measure out of control under the old covenant, how much all the more under the new covenant through the shed blood of Jesus. Man, when I said that on Sunday, you guys went ballistic. It's the truth. He's more than enough. How much is he more than enough under the new covenant? Oh yeah. But like we've been reading in Psalm, we're not going to go there tonight. In Psalm 133, verses 1, 2, and 3. How good and pleasant it is for brethren to dwell together in unity. Like oil being poured down the beard of Aaron. We're not going to turn it, I'm just quoting it. We're not going to read it, but I'm just quoting a little bit. How good and pleasant it is for brethren to dwell together in unity, like oil being poured down the beard of Aaron, the head, Aaron, the head, the priest, being poured down to the bottom of his garment to those who are in alignment. That blessing came upon them. Verse 3, where God commanded blessings and life. He threw that in there too. He commanded blessings and life forevermore, which means a continual abundance of infinite, out of control blessings. There you go. Woohoo! Mante kerabosa tarabaka. There you go. Some of you are just tuning in. God bless you. We love you. Yep. Sava, the uncontrollable, out of control, overflowing, direct, authoritative, appointed, governing, overseeing, military, mandated orders commanded by the dominion and declaration of the divine favor of El Shaddai, the God who's more than enough. Sava! Next time if there's a loud motorcycle going by, a real loud one, and if you hear me yell, Sava! You'll know why. I mean, if it's really loud. Hey, getting back to the drive-in service. This past Sunday, you guys went nuts. You guys went wild. Nothing stops you from coming together. More importantly, nothing stops you guys from dwelling together. I love it. We're dwelling together right now. But there's nothing like face to face, right? I love it. But this Sunday, 10 a.m., somebody comment, this Sunday, 10 a.m., drive-in service, the meteorologists, y'all, the meteorologists are telling us, be prepared for 72 degrees and sunny this coming Sunday, the second week of November. They're saying, be prepared. Now, I'm not prophesying. And let me just stop there for a moment. This is what I love about nights like this, just to be led by the Lord. Prophets, or people who prophesy, always wait upon the Lord to receive your prophecies. Many people prophesy many things. I'm just going to be very careful right now because I don't want to go further than God would have me. In time I will. But prophets, now church, do not throw stones and do not be judgmental. But prophets, when you give words from the Lord, and if they do not come to pass, now sometimes there are conditions involved on our behalf. Somebody may say, well, she prophesied over me, he prophesied over me, and it did not come to pass. Well, there are things you have to do to make it come to pass. There are things you have to do to make it come to pass. I shared this like about 2 months ago, and April Wells, out of nowhere, came up with a list of things I've shared over the last 5 years about how to allow your prophetic word to come to pass. I know many of you know as well, but I looked on my phone a couple months ago, it was like zoom, like that. So wow, you know, I know you guys believe the same thing, the same way. But when prophecy comes to pass, you have to do warfare over it. You have to sow over it. You have to speak over it. But then there are prophecies that people give that say, you know what? This is what's going to happen, no matter what. And I really don't want to get into that tonight. I want to continue to operate with the wisdom of the Lord. It's His wisdom and it's His time. But I will say, hey, Cuz, how you doing, buddy? Love you, man. But I will say, prophets, when you prophesy, God holds us accountable. And listen, prophets are not perfect. Prophets are human beings. We are subject to make mistakes. So maybe you've given a prophecy and it was inaccurate. It did not come to pass. I'll tell you a funny story. True story. A few years ago, a prophet not far from here came to our church. He was not a speaker. He just visited our church. True story. Gospel truth. True story. And he said to me, God's telling me to tell you that you're going to get your wife pregnant and have a child and have a son. It was just a few years ago. Now, folks, I'm going to be 64. In fact, in a year and a half almost, I'll be on Medicare. But he prophesied. Now, listen, if that's a word from God, you know, I know what you're thinking about Abraham and Sarah. They laughed, right? But I knew that that was not a word from the Lord for me. But I honored the man. Hear me. I honored the man. I did not judge him. I did not judge him. Well, it's safe to say that my wife did not get pregnant. But I love this man. I love this man. And sometimes, folks, and here's where I'm going, it's okay to say, this goes for me, for you, for anybody, for any of the prophecies that you've heard this past week, past month, past year, 5 years, 10 years, just say, I was wrong. Humble yourself and say, I was wrong. Now again, sometimes it was that individual that did not activate the prophetic word. But many times people just prophesy things, guaranteed, says the Lord, this is what's going to happen. And it doesn't happen. And they go in hiding. Or they come out and they never address it. You see, if you just say, I'm human, I made a mistake, people will forgive you. See, some people underestimate people. I don't ever want to do that. People want to forgive people. I can go somewhere with that. People want to forgive people. But God resists the proud, but He gives grace to the humble. So it's okay to say, I was wrong. Sometimes even in my relationship with my wife, if my attitude's not where it's supposed to be, Babe, I'm sorry. I was wrong. So, in the prophetic, if you're going to grow and if God's going to entrust you, because we're a prophetic church, we're an apostolic prophetic church. If God's going to use you in the prophetic, use wisdom, timing. Remember, there's safety in the multitude of counsel. Use wisdom and timing, counsel. And if you're wrong, don't look at somebody and say, well, it's their fault. Just say, I was wrong. And somebody else in the future, if you have a prophecy for them, they just may believe you. But if you don't come clean with it, you're not going to be respected. Now, I'm sharing all this. Sometimes I say, I don't know why. But now I do know why. Because to receive the uncontrollable blessing from the Lord, the commanded blessing, you have to humble yourself.
And if you messed up, humble yourself. If you said something inappropriately, humble yourself. It goes for me, goes for you, goes for us. Humble yourself under the hand of God, the word says, and you'll be exalted. It's all part of the uncontrollable blessing. I'm off my notes right now. I'm just prophesying. We want this out of control anointing, and it's coming upon us. And you survived it through the elections by not taking sides with people. Yes, having the privilege to vote for whoever you voted for. Yes. But not making that your doctrine. There's a difference. Not putting your hope in anyone but the Lord. There's a difference. But praying for those in authority. All right. This is what I love about Wednesday night. Yep. Yep. Sometimes it's okay to say, I was wrong. I was wrong. I've heard a lot of prophecies about a lot of people, and they did not come to pass. Just say, I was wrong. And you'll be respected for that. We're of Abraham's seed, as you know. And there's what, 7-8 billion people on earth? We're part of a seed, Father Abraham. And we have the Abrahamic declaration. We have that. That belongs to you. It's out of control. I love it. Uncontrollable. God used Moses, as we said Sunday, to part the Red Sea and save many, many Jews, multitudes of Jews coming out of Egypt, parting the Red Sea. God rescued all of them. That's out of control. Ezekiel, his vision of revival. You know how it is. You know the verses in Ezekiel 47. The ankles, the knees, the waist, too deep, out of control. I just want to be out of control and love, in love with him. Where my love for him is so out of control. That's why he died on the cross, because his love was uncontrollable. That's why he said, it is finished. Because his love is out of control. And tonight, I plead with you. I plead with me. Let our love be out of control. Let our love be out of control. I'm going to love you more than I've ever loved you. I'm going to love his people, his ministers and ministries. I want to love any and everyone more than ever before. May his love be out of control in your life. After all, isn't that the greatest blessing? The love that never fails. Out of control love that goes the distance. Out of control love where you can turn the other cheek. Uncontrollable love where you forgive 70 times 7. Santo kutera buku satara basatara baka. I feel this anointing, folks. And you know what? I feel you. I feel you right now, church. I really do. Lord, may your love be branded upon us even more. May we embrace your love. Lord, that we can love what some would say are the unlovable. Brand us, Lord, with your love that's out of control, I pray. The love that shakes it off. The love that's free to forgive. The love that says, in spite of what you called me, in spite of what you said about me, my love is out of control because I'm connected to Christ. Because he's the vine and I'm the branch. And so long as I just hang on, my love, which is the fruit of the Spirit, will grow even more. Out of control.
too deep, where you can love people that you thought were difficult to love out of control. I want to tell you something. I love Donald Trump. I love Joe Biden. I sincerely, with all my heart, as God is my witness, I do. Let our love for each other be out of control. Jesus said, out of your belly, out of your spirit shall flow rivers, rivers of living water. Like Ezekiel's rivers, out of your belly shall flow rivers of living water. Peter and some of the disciples, they went fishing. And they caught multitudes of fish. The Bible says they were astonished. Broke the nets. Out of control. We want to catch fish out of control. Souls for the kingdom. Fishers of men. There's so much more here, but you're getting it. The young boy had five loaves. And two small fish. And Jesus fed thousands and had so much left over. Uncontrollable. Uncontrollable. There's so much more to this. But like the word says in Deuteronomy 29:9, keep the words of my command. His command is that we love. Keep the words of my commanded covenant, his covenant of love. And the Lord says, if you keep my covenant, if you love your neighbor, love those that persecute you. Don't love what they do, love them. If you keep my word, says the Lord, my commanded covenant, says the Lord, of love. I will keep my, says the Lord, my uncontrollable, commanded blessings and favor to prosper you in all that you do. There's so much more here. I can go on and on and on. Selfless love. Selfless love. Brand us, Lord, with your love. In these trying days, our love, Lord, our submission, our accountability to you, to each other, that we may dwell together in Jesus' name. This has been the word of the Lord. This has been the word of the Lord. His love never fails. His uncontrollable love. All these prayer requests from Sunday. In Jesus' name, the love of God shed abroad in our hearts by the Holy Ghost be poured upon you now. Be poured upon you now. Healing, deliverance, healing, deliverance. All the people of the church, blessed. Our Facebook friends, blessed. Pastor Eddie with the youth, blessed. This Sunday, 10 a.m., drive-in service, blessed. Blessed coming in, blessed coming out. Babe, if you would come on up here. You know, love, when we started talking about love, it just, something just hit me.
I saw that.
We know it's the Lord.
It's what you've been ministering on, but the uncontrollable love. Love that knows no limits. Just uncontrollable love.
Love that knows no limits. Somebody comment that.
Thank you, Lord.
Wow. Wow. It's always different, isn't it? Wednesday nights.
Yeah.
Uncontrollable love. Over the next few days in America, in your village, in your home,
in your life. And you know what? Love yourself.
Yes.
Don't be in love with yourself. Love yourself. You deserve a break today.
That's right.
And again, we're so proud of you.
Amen.
We were proud of our son when he tried to hit that baseball. By the way, he became a very good baseball player.
Yes.
But we just want to tell you how proud we are of you.
Yes, absolutely.
And now we're going to receive our tithes and offerings. And I declare your harvest blessed, out of control,
Lord.
According
blessed,
to 2 Corinthians 9:8, overflowing out of control,
yes.
Abounding for every good work,
Amen.
And having more than enough.
Amen.
In Jesus' name.
In the name of Jesus.
If you want to call the church in with your credit card, you can do that. If you get the answering machine, somebody will get back to you. You can go to PayPal
That's
if
right.
you'd like. On the bottom of the screen, you'll see the website. If you want to come to the church and drop in your tithes and offerings, or if you did it on Wednesday, whatever, God bless you. We love you so much.
We do.
The joy of the Lord is your strength.
It sure is.
And one day Jesus is going to come back.
Yes.
For a glorified church. There'll
yes.
be no more sickness, no more pain.
Hallelujah.
But until then, we're going to walk in those uncontrollable blessings.
That's right.
Out of control.
And be at peace.
And be at peace.
Mm-hmm.
Because the devil will test you, tempt you, to get you out of unity,
yeah.
from dwelling together.
Right.
Mm-mm. Mm-hmm. But we're like Joel's army, Gideon's gang,
yes.
and Elisha's company.
Yes.
We stay in position. And that's why
Amen.
God's changing our condition.
Amen.
So we pray your tremendous Thursday, fabulous Friday, sensational Saturday, and Super Sunday.
Super Sunday.
Feel free to watch this again. Feel free to keep commenting, keep sharing, share with a
right.
friend. We want them to know about our Jesus.
Yes.
We thank the Lord for you again, for your tremendous Thursday. Again, your fabulous Friday, sensational Saturday, and Super Sunday. Babe, if our arms were long enough, one big hug.
One big hug.
Lips big enough.
One big kiss.
One big kiss. And remember, it's okay to say I was wrong.
That's right.
It's okay. I was wrong. I was wrong. Mm-hmm. Babe, I was wrong.
I was wrong.
Oh, about what? No, just kidding. Love you guys. God bless you so much.
Big.
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 Mucho grande.
Big.
God bless you all. We love you.
Good night.